Hi, I'm Rob from Ski Press, and I'm here at the Ski and Snowboard Show at Earls Court to check out what's happening this week. I've come along to the Chez Serre Chevalier stand to meet Duncan from Chez Serre Chevalier and Darren Turner from Inside Ski in Serre Chevalier. Hi guys, how's it going?
Good. Very well, thank you.
So Duncan, tell us a little bit about Serre Chevalier.
Well, I think there's probably two things that the first-time visitor to Serre Chevalier should definitely know about. The first is that it's a really big resort, and the second is that it's fantastic value. It's got 250 kilometres of piste, which are really well linked, and it's a very snowshore resort as well, because you've got north-facing slopes lower down, and once you're up above 2,000 metres, it's all really lovely, open and sunny, but you're up at a height where the snow's going to stay, whatever. And the second thing, as I said, is it's a fantastic value resort, both when you're booking your holiday up front, and then once you're out there, if you want to go and get a beer, get some food on the mountain, or go out for a meal in the evening. And actually, it's 20% cheaper than the average large French ski resort. So at a time when there's maybe a little bit less money around, it offers a fantastic option for people to still get that really big ski in, but it costs a bit less on the wallet.
Okay. So Serre Chevalier is located in the southern French Alps, is that correct?
That's absolutely right. Yeah, basically, if you're maybe around the Tarentaise resorts and the Three Valleys, which a lot of people know, you just pop over the Galibier from there and you're into the Serre Chevalier Valley. It's really easy to get to. You can fly to Turin, Grenoble or Lyon. It's a couple of hours transfer from any of those. Or if you fancy it, you can actually get the overnight train from Paris as well, which brings you into Briançon. And then you're right in the action just 5 or 10 minutes from your accommodation.
All right. So Darren, you run Inside Ski School in Serre Chevalier.
I do.
What sort of levels of skier do you have coming out to see you?
The great thing is it's all levels, you know. We go right from the beginners to expert training instructors. And for me, working in ski instruction every day, I think it's nice to have a varied level. Not always the same level. Break it up and yeah, you get a lot more diversity really.
Okay, so in terms of skiing in Serre Chevalier, what sort of standard of skier is suited in Serre Chevalier?
And it sounds like a cliche, but it really is open to everybody. There's so many different things. We've got some of the best tree skiing in France by far. We don't actually have a lot of pine trees, they're larch trees, and they're spaced that little bit further apart, so the runs are actually more open inside the trees. And for those guys really wanting to push it, we're only just a stone's throw away from Le Grave. So a 45-minute drive to Le Grave for those guys wanting to really push it and experience off-piste and a beautifully high mountain, right. You know, there's a lot of options.
I mean, Le Grave, for example, is a pretty tough place to ski. Do you have to go there with a guide or an instructor?
Yeah, if you don't know the place, I would definitely recommend going with a guide. You've got some of the best skiers in the world that hang out in that place. You don't want to be following a pair of tracks that you don't know whose tracks they are. So yeah, definitely advise a guide or instructor to take you there.
So what about like in the evenings in Serre Chevalier? Is it a good place for après-ski as well, Duncan?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think there's plenty of places to go out, plenty of lively bars, some really, really good restaurants, and as I say, excellent value as well. But I think the other thing about Serre Chevalier is that it offers a unique French experience. It's not a purpose-built resort. It's a real place, so to speak, and you've got lovely traditional villages and you get that authentic, rustic charm that, you know, maybe in some other places isn't quite there. And then, of course, you've got, as well as the three main villages of Menetier, Chantemel and Villeneuve, you've got Briançon town as well, which has got the medieval old town there, which is really fantastic experience. So you can get a bit of culture in alongside your ski holiday as well. So it's a really great place to go out, yeah.
So Darren, UK clients coming out to see you this year. How do you think we can get more British people to come out to Serre Chevalier?
Well, I think things like this, you know, we're at the ski show, Chez Serre Chevalier here, flying the flag for Serre Chevalier and just making that awareness. I mean, I had guys from Russia, Romania, all over the place coming to ski in Serre Chevalier, and it is really, I couldn't agree with Duncan more, that it's an underestimated place and a lot of people come once and then we see them year after year. So that's got to say something.
All right. Great. Thanks, guys. Thanks for telling us about Serre Chevalier.
Pleasure. Cheers. Thanks very much.
Thanks.